Tim Helene on Facebook Live asks the following. When the apostles came across converts who had the baptism of John only, were those people rebaptized, or were hands laid on the apostles only to complete the baptismal rite? And please explain.
It's a great question. And you're referring to the first six verses of Acts chapter 19. And you had the story immediately before that one in Acts chapter 18 of Apollos, who was a disciple of John only and believed in Jesus. And the Bible says he was convincing the Jews mightily. He was fervent in the Spirit. That's another example of what we were talking about before, of someone who doesn't have the fullness of truth yet, but is already operating in the Spirit. He's fervent in the Spirit, convincing the Jews mightily in the Scriptures. And it was Priscilla and Aquila who met him, and then they led him to the way more perfectly. And he was baptized, and of course he becomes one of the great apostles in the secondary sense of the word, right, of the first century. He was with Paul in Acts 14:14, referred to as an apostle. So it's a great story. But now in Acts 19, we see in Ephesus, there were certain believers that Paul and the Christians encountered there who believed, kind of like Apollos, only knowing the baptism of John. And it's interesting, the dialogue, how it goes. Because when they encounter them, they say, have you heard that there is of the Holy Spirit? And they go, well, we've never heard of the Holy Spirit. And they said, well, then in what name were you baptized? Obviously, they knew if you were baptized validly, and you would have known what the Holy Spirit is. So, well, in what name were you baptized? And they said, we were baptized with John's baptism. And so they took them and had to baptize them, laid hands on them, and they received the fullness of the Holy Spirit. So just like with Apollos, they need to be baptized properly. But I think both of these stories are great examples of what we do here at Catholic Answers, is we meet folks all different levels.
Right.
You've got Mormons who are not Christians, they don't have valid baptism, or Jehovah's Witnesses who don't have valid baptism.
Right.
But you have some, you know, our Baptist brothers and Orthodox and such who do. So we minister to all right where they are. So the answer is they would have to be baptized because they did not have a valid baptism in Jesus' name, or in other words, Jesus' baptism, which is in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit.